Narrow pupil with or without. Here I am going to present two cases of echo emulsification with narrow pupil. Here is the first case of an nuclear cataract with narrow pupil and fine pupillary membrane. Here I choose to use Mallugin ring, but before inserting the ring, I stretch the pupil as it's clear to facilitate the insertion of the Mallugin ring. You can see the pupil now is slightly bigger than before, and here is the Mallugin ring is inserted, and the last loop was fixed in the pupil edge using a bifurcated forceps as it's clear. And now you can see the pupil is about 6 millimeters. Now dealing with this case became easier with this large pupil. You can see the pupil now, it's about 6 millimeters in diameter. Using the cystatome to create anterior capsular incision, then complete the rexes with forceps, then doing hydrodissection and emulsifying this soft cataract, is not dense cataract, was easy. Then after removing this cataract, washing the cortex using the bimanual irrigation aspiration, then single piece hydrophobic IOL implanted inside the capsular bag as it's clear. And now before washing the viscoelastic material, it's the time to remove the Mallugin ring as it's clear. Using the injector of this ring, you can just release two eyelets and then removing from the anterior chamber, then washing the OVD from the anterior chamber and also behind the IOL. Here you can see the pupil is becoming irregular, and the surgery went smoothly and it was very good result by the end of the surgery, then doing stromal hydration. Here is the second case with narrow pupil, but here the pupil looks slightly bigger than previous case. After doing 2.2 millimeter clear corneal incision and injecting dispersive OVD, the capsulorhex here should be larger than the pupil diameter, so the edge of my rhexis should be behind the iris. Complete hydrodissection in this case is important while doing phaco emulsification through the narrow pupil, so you will be sure that the nucleus is freely rotated, which can facilitate the chopping of this cataract through this small pupil. Now doing the phaco emulsification of this nuclear cataract through this narrow pupil using the horizontal chop technique, holding the nucleus at the center of the pupil, then go by the chopper at the equator and chop it into halves. Then you can chop each half alone into smaller pieces and emulsify all these pieces at the level of the pupil as you see in this case. You can see the pupil is narrower than before. You can see all your work should be at the level of the pupil, at the center of the pupil. After chopping the nucleus into smaller pieces and emulsify each piece alone, you can see this is a protective shell. By the end of the surgery, you can just aspirate it with slightly ultrasound power. You can see the emulsifying of this cataract was done perfectly. You can see the pupil is very narrow while removing the cortex using the bimanual irrigation aspiration. Now the pupil is about 2 or 2.5 millimeters in diameter. You can push the iris with the irrigation probe while removing the cortex with the aspiration probe. You can see the cortex has been washed perfectly. Now you can inject cohesive OVD and implanting a single piece hydrophobic IOL inside the capsular bag and then removing the viscoelastic from the anterior chamber and also behind the IOL. You can see here also the surgery went smoothly and it was perfect. By the end of the surgery, you can see the pupil is rounded and is not irregular. And finally, doing stromal hydration. And thank you for watching this video.